my gift is, you shall be eaten last.
Then he fell into a drunken sleep.
Quick, my friends, put the steak in the fire.
When it was glowing, Ulysses grasped the flaming steak and thrust into the eye of the Cyclops.
He shall pay with his only eye for the lives of my men.
With an agonizing cry, Cyclops leapt up and roared so loudly that the neighboring, round-eyed people gathered to see what had happened.
That ails you that you make such an uproar? Is anyone trying to hurt you? No man is hurting me. Well, if no man is hurting you, then it must be gods, and we cannot help you against them.
Telling Cyclops thy name was no man deceived his people.
Ulysses was still in doubt, however, as to how he and his men should escape, for the giant sat in the mouths of the cave and felt to see if the men were trying to flee. Finally, Ulysses had a plan.
Bring me 6 of the biggest sheep.
Then beneath each animal, Ulysses tied one of the 6 men left out of the 12. In the morning, the flock went out of the cave and Cyclops felt them as they passed, but he did not discover the men. But there was no one to tie Ulysses to a sheep. As last animal hurried by, Ulysses desperately grabbed hold and swung beneath. As last animal approached, the bewildered Cyclops jumped to his feet, hoping to trap Ulysses. Ulysses slipped from the animal as Cyclops cried,
I wish you could speak and tell me where no man is. I would dash his brains upon the ground.
Beneath the very nose of the Cyclops, Ulysses quickly released the men.
That was close.
And cautioned them to make haste to the boat. One of the men shouted excitedly,
I see the boat now.
When they were offshore, Ulysses answered the crew's anxious questions.
In this one I had Cyclops devoured 6 of our companions.
When they were 100 yards from shore, Ulysses shouted to the giant,
Thou art an evil beast, Cyclops, and well deserve to lose thine eye.
This enraged Cyclops, who seized a huge boulder and threw it in the direction of Ulysses' voice. Cyclops' aim was almost perfect. The boulder plummeted toward the prow of the vessel.
We are being swept back to the beach.
But Ulysses caught up a long pole and pushed the galley off.
the giant shall know who destroyed his eye.
Master, do not anger the monster again.
But not content, Ulysses insisted defying the Cyclops.
Hear, mighty Cyclops. Know it was Ulysses of Ithaca who put out thine eye.